Myself CS Patel from MCGM virtual class welcome all of you. Due to the global pandemic, this year's educational season is being affected. In such a situation, our Brihanmumbai Municipal Corporation has taken an initiative to provide every student online education. So let's get started.
Standard 9th. Yes, you are seeing my English course book, Standard 9th. Subject English. Yes, so today's lesson is The Necklace Part 1. A nice story, students, we will see today. The Necklace Part 1. And students, myself, C.S. Patel from Virtual Training Center, Dadar, Mumbai. So students, yes, now see about the writer of this story, The Necklace. Writer Guy Maupassant, Henry René Albert Guy Maupassant, was a 19th century French author, remembered as the master of the short story form and as a representative of nationalist school, who depicted human lives and destinies and social forces disillusioned and often pessimistic term. Born 5th August 1850 in France and died 6th July 1893 in Paris, France. Just yes, students, short story is very famous. The Necklace, yes, you are seeing Guy de Maupassant, writer of the today's story, The Necklace. The Necklace Part 1. Yes, students, sir. See, Mathilde was a pretty and charming girl, born as if by an error of fate into a family of clerks. She had no means of becoming known, understood, loved, or to be wedded to an aristocrat, and so she let herself be married a minor official at the Ministry of Education. So students, you are seeing Necklace, and the first character of this story is Mathilde. Yes, you are seeing. So Mathilde was a pretty and charming girl, was born as if by an error of fate into a family of clerk, means in a middle class family. Our lower middle class family, she had no means of becoming known, understood, loved, or to be wedded and an aristocrat. So aristocrat means anything regarded as the best. So yes, she was thinking about, and so she let herself be married to a minor official at the Ministry of Education. Yes, you are seeing students, Mathilde, and the story moves around Mathilde. In this story, we will see. Yes, students, so Mathilde was a pretty and charming girl, but students, you have seen that she was so much ambitious, and though she was very pretty, but we will see in this story further how and what destiny plays an important role for her life. In this lesson, we'll see. She dressed plainly because she had never been able to afford anything better. Yes, you are seeing about Mathilde's, we can say Mathilde's lifestyle. She suffered endlessly, feeling she was entitled to all luxuries of life. She suffered because of her shabby. So yes, shabby means in poor condition through long use, poorly furnished house. All these things that another woman of her class would not even have noticed, tormented. Yes, her and made her resentful. Resentful means unhappy. Yes, she dreamed of a grand palatial mansion. Palatial mansion means grand palace. Yes, you are seeing right side. Whatever you are seeing, see the image right side. She was thinking about that palatial mansion. But in the left side, see, that was his current future. That was his current position, you can say. So, students, she was so ambitious. But see, students, yes, with vast room and inviting smaller rooms perfumed for afternoon chats with close friends. Means, Mathilde was thinking, she was thinking about a good lifestyle, but there was no luck, you can say. So she was just living as a middle class family. See further what happened. Tormented means physical or mental suffering. Yes, tormented means physical or mental suffering. It she had no rich dress, no jewels, nothing, and these were the only things she loved. She wanted much to charm, to be invited, to be sought after. Invite means desire to have a quality. Invite means desire to have a quality. Yes, she had a rich friend, a former schoolmate at the convent, whom she avoided visiting because afterwards she would weep with regret, despair and misery. See, students, see adjectives. Regret, despair and misery. See right side image you are seeing. Yes, Mathilde's friend. We will see her name further. But yes, means students, whom she avoided visiting. Why? Because yes, with great regret, despair and misery. Yes. So one evening her husband came home with an air of triumph. Triumph means victory, holding a large envelope in his hand. Look, see, he said, here's something for you. She tore open the paper and drew out a card on which was printed the words. Yes, so her husband entry here, and he has given an envelope. So what's written there? See, the Minister of Education, and yes, ma'am, Georges Rampono requests the pleasure of M and M Loisel, Mr. and Mrs. Loisel's company at the ministry on the evening of Monday, January 18th. Yes, in this letter written, instead of being delighted as her husband had hoped, she threw the invitation on the table resentfully. Resentfully means totally unhappy and muttered, what do you want to me with that? And what do you accept me to wear if I go? Means, students, yes, what do you expect me to wear if I go? He hadn't thought of that. He stammered. So, students, yes, now stammered means speak with sudden involuntary pause. Why? The dress you go to the theater in, it seems very nice to me. But students, she was not ready. Miss Mathilde was not ready. Then what happened? We will see further. He stopped, stunned, distressed to see his wife's crying. She stuttered, what's the matter? Let's see, Mathilde. How much would a suitable dress cost? She thought for a moment. Yes, computing the cost and also wondering what amount she could ask for without an immediate refusal. At last, she answered hesitantly, I don't know exactly, but I think I could do it with 400 francs. So, students, if she should go in party, means Mathilde should go in party, yes, she wanted to buy new cloth. And see, students, how she is forcing, she is saying to her husband that, yes, and she was thinking about without an immediate refusal, means her husband should not refuse. So at last she has decided and she asked 400 francs. Yes, so 400 francs, students, yes, you know, francs, this story, students, you know, written by students, you know, the writer is related to France. So francs, yes, currency which is used in France. Okay, now we'll see further. Stuttered means talk with continued involuntary repetition of sound. Yes, he was repeating his sound again and again, so repetition of the sound, but involuntary, because he was surprised. He turned a little pale because he had been saving the exact amount to buy a gun for hunting somewhere in a country near Nanterre with a few friends. However, he said, very well, I can give you 400 francs, but try and get a really beautiful dress. The day of the party drew near and Madame Loisel seemed sad, restless, anxious, though her dress was ready. Means, students, he turned a little pale, means his husband was not ready, but anyhow, because why he was not ready? Because yes, he wanted to buy a gun for hunting in summer season, but now these francs he will use for Mathilde's dress. Okay, students, so now see further. One evening her husband said to her, what's the matter? You have been acting strange these last 3 days. She replied, I'm upset that I have no jewels, not a single stone to wear. I would rather not to go to the party. So students, see here, now dress is ready, but she is still upset, means Mathilde is upset. And now she said, yes, I would rather not go to the party. You would, and her husband said, you could wear flowers. He said, they are very fashionable at the time of year. But students, see what happened. Means they are very fashionable at the time of year. Means her husband is saying, but now, she was not convinced. The next day, she went to her friend's house and told her of her distress. So, students, distress means upset, means pida, kast. Yes, now, next day, she went to her friend's house and her name was Madame Forestier. So Madame Forestier went to her mirrored wardrobe, took out a large box, brought it back, opened it and said to Madame Loisel, choose, my dear. First, Mathilde saw some bracelets, then a pearl of necklace. She tried on jewelry in the mirror. She kept asking, you have nothing else. Why? Yes, but I don't know what you like. Suddenly she discovered a black satin box. So black satin bark. Satin means students, a smooth cloth, but black. Yes, smooth cloth, black. So she has a superb diamond necklace, and her heart began to beat with uncontrolled desire. Means students, you are seeing. Yes, now. See, students, satin box, black satin box. Yes. So you are seeing black satin box, a super diamond necklace, and her heart began to beat with uncontrolled desire. Means now her hands trembled. Tremble means students, kapana. Yes, so moving as she took it. She fastened it around her neck and stood lost in ecstasy as she looked at herself. Now, students, she wanted to go very soon, because now she was thinking that whatever she was seeing means this black, this was in black satin box, means necklace, a superb necklace was there in this black satin box. And then what happened the next scene start in the story? Then she asked anxiously, hesitating, would you lend me this, just this? Why? Yes, of course. She threw her arm around her friend's neck. Yes, now rapturously, then fled with her treasure. Now students, fled with her treasure means she wanted to go quickly, because she get. Yes. So students, would you lend me just this? Why? Yes, of course. The day of the party arrived. Madame Lajol was a success. She was prettier than all the other women, elegant. And she, gracious, smiling and full of joy, she danced wildly with passion, forgetting everything in triumph. Triumph means victory, of her beauty and success floating in the cloud of happiness. Means students, now Mathilde was so in excitement. She was very happy. So students, if I say about summary, so she was very happy, and she was prettier than all the other women, elegant, gracious and smiling and full of joy. And she danced wildly means very much. She was dancing without stopping. So yes, and students, what happened the next? See, Mathilde and her husband left at about 4 o'clock in the morning. Means students, yes, you have seen that they were so much busy in the party that it was around 4 o'clock in the morning. तो बच्चों यहाँ देखिए, पार्टी में इतने बिजी थे, लगभग 4 बजने को आ गए, यानी भोर होने को आ गई. When they were finally in the street, they could not find a cab. They walked down toward the Seine till they found one. Yes, they were dropped off at their door in the Rue de Matard, and sadly, it was all over for her. In front of the mirror, she took a final look at herself in all her glory. Glory means happiness. But what happened? Means students, jaise hi Mathilde ghar pahunchti hai anyhow, and she was standing in front of the mirror. Jaise hi mirror ke saamne khadi hui, what happened? Kya dekhti hai? The necklace was not there. Means necklace gap tha. But suddenly she uttered a cry. Achanak jor se chillai. She no longer had the necklace round her neck. What is matter? Asked her husband. She turned toward him, panic stricken. I have. Means I have. But what? I no longer have Madame Forrester's necklace. He stood up, distraught. What? How? That's impossible. Means students, you are seeing that how Mathilde was happy, how she danced, yes, without stopping. But what happened while reaching at home? She have lost the necklace, and now this was landed. What will do? Yes. So now he was saying, yes, that's impossible. Means what will happen in future? Students, in the second part, we will see about what happened, how they worked hard, and what happened, the nice story. Yes, we will see in the second part. So students, now concluding here, practice, try to converse this story with your parent or your classmate. What do you think about Mathilde's ambition? So I think you should converse, yes, to your classmate or your parent or elder. Okay students,
So students, subscribe BMC channel and press the bell icon to get all notifications. Students, we have completed today's session. So work hard. We will meet later. Thank you very much.